Hi everybody, welcome back. I have a special presentation for you. We're going to do a little bit of origami. I'm going to show you some tips and tricks on paper folding. It's an old oriental trick called origami, oriental paper folding. Okay, so we can start out with a square piece of paper. This right here is an 8.5 by 11, so if you don't have any origami paper that's already square, you know, perfectly square with a certain solid color on one side and white on the other side, I'll teach you how to make a square piece of paper out of an 8.5 by 11. That's what this is. Okay. And I'll try to be as soft-spoken as possible. And this is for ASMR purposes, autonomous sensory meridian response purposes. Alright, so this is how we make a square piece of paper out of an 8.5 by 11. First, you take the paper like this, and you fold it diagonally. You want to make sure your corners are as crisp and sharp as possible so that you don't have any future problems along the way when making your origami piece. Okay? Try to be as loud but as soft-spoken as possible. Then we have our triangle right there. It's a little bit of geometry involved. Then we're going to take a fingernail and make a sharp crease there. Thumbnail, make sure it's pretty. And so, see this excess right here? A little bit of excess right here. We don't want that. We're going to take it turned over, flip it back over again like this. I'm going to take out the excess. Make sure you get it close to the edge as possible. The art of Japanese paper folding, or the art of Oriental paper folding. We're not too sure where it comes from, whether it comes from Japan or somewhere else, okay? But we're going to continue the ages-old, thousand-year-old tradition, couple thousand years, actually. We're not too sure how old it is or how far back it goes. Okay, now that you have folded away, you're going to take a thumbnail and run a sharp crease. The edge right there. And the reason why we're doing this is because we want to make a perforation right there. We want to make a tear right there. So we're going to take it, flip it around like this, unfold it a little bit. We're just going to get it started, you know, make a little bit of a tear there. Just to get it started. And make sure you have the sleeves out of the way. I hope I don't embarrass myself, but I'm going to try and tear this as slowly as possible. Now we have a square piece of paper with a diagonal crease in the center. Now we're going to take it, take another diagonal crease. Make sure that your crease matches up with the corner as much as possible to prevent future delays and future hangups. So match up the corners right there. Okay, then we're going to unfold it like this. Then we're going to take the corners, fold them towards the center like this. send it out. We're going to pull the other corner into the center like this. And we keep doing this until all the corners are folded into the center. Get that well done, good. You're doing just fine. If you could follow along with me, it takes a little bit of practice. I've been doing this since I was about 9 years old. My dad went out and bought me a book called Origami by Robin Harbin. I don't know if you know that author. Robin Harbin is a famous author of origami books. You might want to check out that book by that author. Robin Harbin, HARBIN. All right, now that we have them all folded in the center, we want to take just two of them, only two of them, not all of them, unfold it, and then fold the corner back into this line right here. Fold it back over. See what I'm doing. Fold it back in. Now hold it up to you like this. See how I got the flattened out parts right here. Flattened out parts right here. Hope you're able to follow along with what I'm doing. Now it's very important how you flip this and turn it around. You want the flat parts right here with no corners to be on the left and the right side. You want to maintain that position as you flip it around. There's a reason for that. So as you flip it over upside down like this, you're going to take the paper and match it up with this center crease right here. That's okay if the corner flips up a little bit. We'll fold it back under in just a second. Can be a little bit of a tricky process, but not as tricky as the last final step. Just fold that back over. So this is what it looks like. Okay, got the diagonal slots right here. Diagonal slots right here. That should look like this, what it looks like on the other side. Now you got your flat right here, flat edge right there. Got your corner folded in right here. Now this is what we want to do. Want to take, fold along those diagonal slots like this. And turn around and do the same thing with the diagonal slots. Alright, and then we want to do it one more time to make another diagonal fold right over the other diagonal fold, except when you make your second diagonal fold over the first one, make sure that when you fold it, the end part of this comes right towards the middle crease right there and doesn't go past it. It can't go past that part, right? So we're going to fold that right there and press down on it to make sure it stays. Then I'm going to do another diagonal fold on the other side over the first diagonal fold. I'm not really a superstitious kind of guy, so I don't believe in jinxing people with origami. I don't believe that happens. I have no ill intentions with the origami. It's just a work of art. It's a form of sculpting to me. Then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Make a second diagonal fold over the first diagonal fold. Make sure the end part of that doesn't go past the crease right there. Okay, very good. Now you see how we got the corners right here, perfectly lined up with this middle crease there. I'm going to take that corner and fold it in towards the center. Talk about making nothing out of something, right? Making something out of nothing. Sure, I said, go get your own dirt, make your own creation, right? See what you can do. Alright, now that we have that, I'm going to show you the front of this, so you know what it looks like. Show you the reverse, so you know what it looks like. Okay, now, this is the tricky final part of the move, and I hope I get it right. I've done this many times before, so I hope I don't embarrass myself. So, you want to maintain that the corners are pressed down. We're gonna try to turn this thing inside out, all right? So we're gonna flip it around. Be very careful how you do it, do it slowly. All right, so what do you have? A boat called a sampan, okay? Well, I'm proud of myself. I'm sure you'll be proud of yourself once you get enough practice. Go up a few times, do things by trial and error. Pretty soon you'll be able to make your own boat called a sampan. How do you like that? Float it in the water, but not for long because the bottom gets soggy. Then it won't float anymore. But you can put it as a decoration on your dresser, on your shelf somewhere. Little decoration there. 3D origami. Now we're going to make something else. Going to make a, what they call a Spanish box. It's also a ketchup bottle holder. So we're going to proceed to make our next square piece of paper. All forms of origami, unless otherwise stated, start out with a square piece of paper, okay? That's what we're going to do. Moving past the simple basics of the bird base, you know, making a flapping bird. Maybe I'll make a flapping bird next time, but we'll do something different this time. We're going to make what's called a Spanish box that has pleated edges. And it's also a ketchup bottle holder. Nice decoration for a restaurant table or even for your own kitchen table. Okay? So we're going to take the excess off right here. Run our thumbnail along the edge so we can take the excess out along the perforation. We'll make our own perforation right here. Perforation. Perforation. Alright. Hope this works. Now we're gonna unfold it once again. I'm gonna get started a little bit. Then we're going to slowly tear, try not to embarrass myself, take out that excess. All so we have a square piece of paper right there, as much as possible. Go as square as much as we can get it. And we're gonna, now that we have the crease along from top to bottom, we're gonna make another crease from side to side by folding the bottom corner up towards the top toward the corner. Now we've got unfolded again, and we're going to fold all the corners toward the center, okay? And I'll give you a little bit of a tip and a trick. If that little crease doesn't line up perfectly with the corner, I would advise that you take not the corner, but the crease and line it up with the center right there with the other crease. That way you avoid running into future problems. Okay, now we're going to do that. Okay, here we go. I'm going to fold down a little bit. Trying to bolt it around counterclockwise or clockwise, whatever you want. Fold right here. And going to. By the way, it's close to 3 o'clock in the morning on Sunday, July 23rd, 2023. I don't know what all the ruckus is about going on upstairs, but I'll try to keep it as soft-spoken as possible. And that's what I mean too. The corner right here, not too much of a sharp corner, and that's a little bit of a problem and delay we just ran into because the corners weren't sharp enough. So everything you do, try to keep the corners sharp. Now, we're going to flip the whole thing around. That's what it looks like on the front, that's what it looks like on the back. Gotta flip the whole thing around. And we're going to fold the center up like this. We're going to fold the center up like this, corner up towards the center. Short little tutorial on how to make a Spanish box, okay? And we're going to see how got the little slots right there, folded up over like that. This is what it looks like. And then we're going to fold up like this. We're making the feet of the base right here. Like that, the feet of the base right here, the corners right here. I'm going to flip it around toward the top. And here's where the pleated edges come in. Now, this is going to be tricky and difficult. That takes some patience, lots of patience. And so, this is what we're going to do. We're going to make the tiniest fold as possible with some big thumb, big fingers as we can. We're going to fold up the corner like this with the center crease facing toward the middle crease right here towards the top corner, and then see how I got it folded up like that. And then we're going to take it, fold it under like that, kind of like in the air paper folding. then we're going to fold it back down again. So you see the pattern right there where I'm doing completing it. Let's see if I can do it one more time. The reason why you want to keep that first fold as tiny as possible so that when you make your final pleat fold, it doesn't tear up the other edges of the paper right here. So we're going to do this for all the different sides here. Do that same thing on the third flap. And we got one more to go after this. Not as tiny as I wanted it to be, but hopefully it works, you know. Anything can be fixable, anything can be fixed within reason, you know, as long as it's not badly damaged. And you see how it's starting to go at an angle like that, we might want to fix that, you know, so. Always okay to unfold it, start a new crease, and fold it again to tidy it up off a little bit. Okay. That way you keep it straight, it won't be getting folded at an angle like that. Okay, here's what I'm talking about. See how. And that's what I mean, that might get a little bit jammed up along the side if you don't make that first fold tiny as possible. So we got one more chance to try. So we're gonna make that fold corner piece tiny as possible. And I'm going to fold it up like this. And I'm gonna continue to pleat away. What's called pleating, PLEATING. That's good enough for right now. See how we got that? Starting to look intricate and beautiful. Got the feet on the bottom of the base right there. Here's where the trick comes in. Just take it down. Go in like this. Gonna pinch it like this. Alright. And then keep working till it goes all in for it. Pinch it. There you go. I'm doing this with regular printer paper, by the way. Well, alright, now, set it back down on the base, on the feet. Make sure everything is dirty. Make sure everything's looking the way you want it to. Voila. You have your own Spanish box. You can put different things in here. Like a Spanish ketchup bottle, if it's big enough. You can do that using a paper placemat at a restaurant somewhere with colorful designs on it, depending on what design they have on the paper placemat at a different restaurant, you know. Now here's my final origami scenario. I'm going to make what's called a Japanese water bomb, and this one is 3D as well. So we're going to make a square piece of paper again. Try to be as fast as possible and careful as possible. Now, got most of the bases covered right here, right? So I think by now we know what we're doing here. Just make a diagonal fold, like a triangle fold, so that we can cut off that excess using preservation. You can use scissors if you want to, but I just prefer to use my thumb, my thumbnail, to make that perforation right there. You can do whatever you want to do. Let's start it a little bit, and let's see how fast we can get this done. Steady, steady. And if we mess up, start over again. Hopefully we don't have to start over. Okay. Very good. Fold, you know, we got the crease from top to bottom. We're gonna fold the bottom corner up like this. And we're gonna fold down like this. And for something different this time. The reason why we want to do it this way, we want to, you know, they're made so that the paper is slightly bending up like this, like a concave kind of a lens. Well, we want to turn it around like this, turn it upside down so that it's like convex, so that the center corner is pointing up like a pyramid. The reason being so is so that we can make a fold, make it easier in the future. So, we're going to fold up like this. That makes the first horizontal fold. Then I'm going to turn it around, make the next horizontal fold. Okay. Hope you're following along with me pretty well. Right, so now that we have a fold made, the reason why we did it that way. So, the reason why it bends in like that, so that we can hold it like this. It really is important which way you have the creases folded, you know, opposite of the other creases, so that you can make it easier to collapse or expand something. So this is the triangle that we're making. Got this crease from top to bottom, from center actually, from down to the bottom. That's the horizontal fold right there. So I'm going to turn it up like this, an inverted triangle with the center piece pointing down. It's a flat part up at the top here. So we're going to take it, take the corner and fold it down towards the center piece. And do the same thing with the other side. And going to do the same thing with that. Anything like that. It's called a Japanese water vine, by the way. I mean, it's supposed to be a remnant to some kind of a copycat of a Japanese water vine, like a Japanese grenade or something, but I don't really believe it was, just a work of art, you know. So we're gonna take these side corners, fold them in towards the center. By the way, if you need guidelines, you can always make your fold in advance, you know, fold it in half over like that, turn it around and fold it in half like that. Then you have your guidelines so that your corners match up right here. So I'm making imaginary guidelines right there. You take your bottom corners up, fold them up like this. Remember, this part has an opening aperture right here. This part has a closed corner here. Part with the closed corners where you want to flip these corner pieces up. And then there's a little pocket right here. I don't know if you can see a little pocket here. And tuck that flap into that pocket. Same thing on the other side. I'm going to fold the corner in towards the center. And I'm going to fold the corner in towards the center, matching tippy top part of the other corner. Alright. So we have an aperture opening at the top here, closed corner at the bottom here. I'm going to flip up these two corners right here that are parallel over that closed corner. Then I'm going to open up that pocket right here on the left side. It's kind of difficult to explain on paper. That's why I'm showing it to you on video. Trying to figure out how to translate from the schematic diagrams in the book to real life. Hands-on experience can be a little bit difficult. It's a little bit of analyzing, a little bit of studying, you know, especially with the Robin Harbin books. Not that it's flawed, you know, it just takes a little bit of mind work, a little bit of brain work trying to decipher what the different lines mean, dashed line, dotted line, regular lines, what the little arrows mean over the dashed line, the dotted lines, you know. Now this is a heavier, thicker paper, so in my past experience, it didn't always work that well. But better if you have lighter paper, thinner paper to work with when you make your Japanese water bottle. But that's about all I have for right now, so I'm making do with less. So that's what this is right here. So in order to finish the project, I'm going to flip the computer down right here. I'm going to show you how to blow this thing up and make it 3D, okay? Japanese water bomb. Alright. So I'm going to blow it, hold it by this part, and by this part, alright? You ready? You got your 3D cube right there. If you want, you take a small pencil and put it into the aperture right here and poke it down so that it's more of a flatter bottom right here than what it already is. Like I said, if you've got thinner paper and you make a sharper blow into that opening aperture at the top, it'll turn into more of a perfect cube. Other than this right here, I know it looks like a piece of garbage to some people, but it's amazing to other people. One man's trash is another man's treasure. That's best I can do. Hope you enjoyed this origami ASMR. Take care and peace out. All right. Thank you very much.